Welcome all. In this session, I am going to discuss you about some problems based on this unit current electricity. So we have initiated the concept of current electricity with the Ohm's law, the mobility, the drift of electrons, and so on. Some basics. So unless if we solve some problems, we cannot completely understand the concept. So we will have a small discussion about the problems based on this topic. So first we, what are the theory we discussed? It is the Ohm's law. What is Ohm's law? The voltage, current and the resistance relationship. So when a voltage is given to a, that is when a potential difference is given to a conducting material, the current flowing through the material is directly proportional to the potential difference, and the current flowing through the material is inversely proportional to the resistance of the material. So I equal to V divided by R. So this two are in direct proportion and this two are in inverse proportion. Okay, a very important formula. And don't think that there are only three variables, and this is a very meaningful formula. And we have n number of problems using this formula. So this plays a very major role in direct current analysis in circuits with the direct current source. Ohm's law. So this problem, the first problem is based on this Ohm's law. I will read the problem now. The storage battery of a car. The storage battery of a car has an EMF of 12 volts. If the internal resistance of the battery is 0.4 ohm, what is the maximum current that can be drawn from the battery? That's the question. So we have to write the given data first. If you extract the given data from the statements very clearly, then 90% of your problem is over. So I will write the given data. The first one is given data. What is the given data? So 12 volts, the voltage. Voltage is 12 volts. The next one is internal resistance of the battery. Internal resistance equal to 0.4 ohm. Then only these two deltas are given vertically. Then what we have to find? What is the maximum current that can be drawn from the battery? So we have to find the current that can be drawn from the battery. That is specifically, that is the maximum current. So that is the maximum current. So to find the current is represented by the symbol I. I max. Then we go for the solution. What is the formula used? The formula that relates the current, voltage, and resistance is Ohm's law. So, as per the Ohm's law, I equals to V divided by R. So here we are finding the maximum current, that is I max equal to V divided by R. That is, what is the voltage? 12 volts. That is divided by 0.4. The answer we get is 30 So Imax is 30 amps. Ampere is the unit of current. So the maximum current that can be drawn from the battery with the EMF of 12 volts and the internal resistance is 0.4. So from each and every problem we can learn a theory or we can revise a theory very clearly. Students, listen here. What is this internal resistance? Internal resistance. So there is a concept behind this internal resistance, because it is like a very basic example is a petrol in your a petrol tank of your bike or a vehicle. It means when there is lack of petrol, when the petrol is completely filled, okay, then there is another concept in the tank itself is reserve. Okay, when the petrol keeps on drying, there will be a reserve amount of petrol. Okay, then you compare the case. Here, the battery itself has a source of current. But what limits the current to flow from the? Not all the petrol will go outside of the petrol bank, petrol tank, to the engine. Some petrol will be reserved. Okay, that will be restricted. Okay, similar to this, that is just a similar example. So there is a limiting factor in the battery itself that limits the current to flow out of the battery. That you call it as an internal resistance. Because what is resistance? Resistance is a property to limit the flow of current. Okay, so this internal resistance means that is inside the battery itself. The battery is also a component. It has its own resistance. It will not allow completely all the current to flow through. It restricts some flow of current. That you call it as the internal resistance. Clear? That will, beyond this only we will get the maximum current. So the maximum current that can be drawn by considering the internal resistance is 30 amperes. So write the problem in this manner. You first write the given data, then to find what is to be found, then the solution, and you write the formula. That is the formula. Then you go for the steps. If you have any doubts, please immediately note down the doubts and write it in the paper. Always write all your problems in the classroom itself. Don't take randomly rough note or test note or any other paper. Whenever you watch a video, you try to follow in sequence in the same notes. Otherwise, you cannot follow the classes. Because in the next session, you may get the answer for the doubts that you had in the previous session. So, you have to have the class and book with you always. Okay, let us move on to the next question. Next one, students. The second problem. A battery of EMF 10 volts and internal resistance 3 ohm is connected to a resistor. So this is the first one. What do they have given? They have given as a battery of 3 volts and internal resistance is also given 3 ohms. If the current in the circuit is 0.5 amps,
that is the current value is also given. What is the resistance of the resistor? That is, we have connected a resistor to the battery. Then, what is the terminal voltage of the battery when the circuit is closed? So, we have to find the value of the resistor and the terminal voltage of the battery. Now, what is the main thing that we have to do in this diode problem is, we have to draw a circuit diagram for the problem. It will be very, very convenient for us for doing a problem if we convert the statements into a diagram. Rather than converting it into a formula, if we first convert the statement into a circuit diagram, the circuit diagram will speak so much than the formulas we write. Clear? The circuit diagram has marks for your answers. Okay? In the answers, the circuit diagram also have marks. If your circuit diagram is very perfect and it synchronizes with the question that is being asked. So, I will draw the circuit diagram first and you draw it parallelly. So, the circuit diagram for this.
A bulb, a fan, a mixie, a grinder, a refrigerator, anything.
electrical load. Everything is represented by its own resistance value in a circuit. We cannot draw a fan here, and we will not be drawing a fan here like this. How do we represent this fan in a circuit? We represent a fan in an electrical circuit with its electrical resistance value. Clear? And now, in this circuit, what they have told is, they didn't give the type of load. They didn't mention the type of load. They just mentioned the resistance value. So, it's enough. It will be very comfortable for us if we write the resistance value. Now, they have not specified the resistance value. They asked us to find the resistance value, provided they have given the current value. What is the current flowing here? 0.5 amps. So when a switch is closed, that is, the current flows only in a closed circuit. So the current of 0.5 amps is flowing in the circuit, and this is the resistance, unknown resistance, R. This resistance I do not know. I have to find the value of resistance. The first thing, what is the resistance? So I am applying the Ohm's law. So I have to find what we have defined to find R. Then what is the second thing they have asked? What is the terminal voltage of the battery when the circuit is closed? So when the circuit is closed only, the current will flow. Only when the circuit is closed, the current will flow. Okay? So I have to find the R value and the terminal voltage, because the voltage consumed by this resistance, or the voltage across this resistance, is the terminal voltage. This is the terminal. Across this terminal, I have connected a resistor. A current of 0.5 amp is flowing to this circuit. Everywhere it is 0.5 only. Current is not splitting anywhere, because only one load is there. Clear? So, only 0.5 amps is flowing everywhere. So, I have to find the resistance R and the voltage across this resistor. What is the voltage? Terminal voltage. This is the terminal voltage. V terminal. That is the terminal voltage. I write it like this, sorry. First one is R, then V terminal. That is, it is a terminal voltage, means the voltage across the resistance. Now, formula. Using Ohm's law, this problem is based on the Ohm's law. So, I am using the Ohm's law. So, Ohm's law, as per the Ohm's law, V equal to I R. Okay, now you analyze the entire circuit. You analyze the entire circuit. For the given voltage, what is the given voltage? 10 volts. The given voltage is 10 volts. And what is the total resistance of the circuit? The internal resistance is 3 ohms. Outside I have a resistance of R. Okay, the source is V. The current 0.5 amps. What is the resistance R? Here this V is 10 volts. The current I is 0.5 amps. So what is R? R is the resistance of the total circuit, not this R. R total, okay? So R means total resistance. R refers to the total resistance of the circuit. So here you have an internal resistance and an external resistance connected. So R total equal to, what is the internal? 3 plus R. You substitute these values in the formula. So what is V10 equal to 0.5 into 3 plus R. So then on evaluating this, expression, the answer I get is R equals to, what that is, 20 minus 3, 17 ohms. The value of the resistance is 17 ohms. After evaluating this, the value I get is 17 ohms. Then, next one I have to find is, what is the terminal voltage? So, terminal voltage means the voltage across this resistor, because what I have connected in the terminal, I have connected a resistor in the terminal. That is, there is a voltage drop in the resistor. There is a voltage drop. Whenever a current is flowing through a resistor, there is a voltage drop in the resistor. So, the terminal voltage is equal to the voltage drop across the resistor. Please listen. The terminal voltage is equal to the voltage drop across the resistor connected to the terminal. Right. So what is the resistance value? 17. What is the current that is flowing? 0.5 amps. So obviously the voltage is, voltage across the terminal is V equal to 0.5 into 17. So V equals to 8.5 volts. So write it clearly. So the voltage across the terminal is V equal to I into R. The I is the current, 0.5 amps. R is 17 ohms. That is 8.5 volts. So write in a proper sequence, students. You must draw this circuit diagram. Only then you can understand this concept. You first see the entire thing. I will move from the video. You just see, and whenever you pause it and you see and write the complete thing. For your complete reference, I have shown you the question, the circuit diagram and the formula, then the steps involved. So you write in a proper sequence when you copy in your notes. So please copy this with a proper sequence in your notes. In some notes or some of your guides, the circuit diagram may not be given to you. You must draw your circuit diagram for your proper reference. So be particular in copying the circuit diagram. The direction of current is very important. It's very better for you to make a block in the source. This is the source. You isolate the source with the block. The switch is important. Then the formula involves the Ohm's law. Okay, students, we'll move on to the next problem. Now, students, the third question is, three resistors, 1 ohm, 2 ohm and 3 ohm are connected in series. What is the total resistance? The first one. The second one is, if the combination is connected to a battery of 12 volts, what is the potential difference, potential drop across each resistor? It's a very, very easy one. The first one is the given data. What is the given data for the first one is resistor. Resistors R1 equal to 1 ohm, R2 equal to 2 ohm, R3
3 ohm.
So this is the given data, and we have to find the R total. And very very easy one, the answer is solution for that, the formula. So the resistance are connected in series. When the resistance are connected in series, when the resistance are connected in series, we have to add the resistance values directly. When the resistance are connected in series, we have to add the resistance directly. So R total equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So what is the value? R total equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3. The which is 6 ohms. R total value is 6 ohms. Okay. So the total resistance of the circuit is 6 ohms. The second one, what I have asked. Now, if the combination is connected to a battery of 12 volts, so when we are connecting a battery of 12 volts to this combination, what is the potential drop across each resistor? We have to find the potential drop across each resistor. What is potential drop? That is the voltage across the each resistor. Because this 12 volt is, this 12 volt is given to these three resistors. They are connected in series. So what is the potential drop across each resistor means? This 12 volt is shared by the three resistors. And we have to find how much of voltage is there in each and every resistor separately. How much of voltage is there in each and every resistor? That we call it as the potential drop. So V, voltage is 1 volt. So we have to use the ohms law. So to find the potential drop, that is the voltage, we need a current concept. So what is the voltage? Voltage is current times the resistor. Voltage is current times the resistor. Excuse me. So voltage is current times the resistance value. So as per the Ohm's law, please copy in sequence, students, please copy it in sequence and write the formula very clearly. I will draw a circuit diagram for it. So as per the Ohm's law, what is the value? Voltage equal to current times resistance. So here resistance is the total resistance. R, what is the voltage given? 12 equal to I into R total. So then I equal to 12 divided by 6. The total resistance is 6 ohms. So I is, which is 2 ampere. Which is, the current in the circuit is 2 ampere. So write it carefully. The current in the circuit is 2 ampere. Now, we got the current value. So what is being asked? What is the potential drop across each resistor? Just we need to find the potential drop across each resistor. The formula for potential drop is current times the resistance value. That is V1 is potential drop across R1. So V1 equal to IR1, which is 2 into, what is R1 value? 1, which is 2 volts. V2, I times R2, I into R2. Why I put I value everywhere? Why I is same everywhere? Because the series is, because it is a series combination. In series combination, the current is constant. In series combination, the current is constant. I will show you with a diagram after this. I into R2, which is 2 times 2, which is 4 volts. Then V3, that is voltage across R3, current times resistance, 2 times 3 ohms, 6 volts. So the voltage across the resistance is 2 volts. The voltage across resistance R2 is 4 volts. Voltage across resistance R3 is 6 volts. So the individual voltage we found. Now we have to check whether the total voltage across the circuit is equal to the source voltage. So total voltage is what? 12 volts. Whether the 12 volt is shared among all the 3 resistors, okay, based on their own resistance value. So you check now, V1 plus V2 plus V3 in series combination, V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So you first copy this, then I will explain it with a diagram. You write in a proper sequence in your classwork. Highlight the formulas very well. And sometimes the hints that I am telling you, you write in the same sentence. That makes very important. I will erase the question. So I am checking now whether the source voltage is equal to the sum of the drops in the circuit. That is, what is source voltage? V equal to 12 volts. The source voltage is 12 volts. What is V1 plus V2 plus V3? That is 2 plus 4 plus 6. So which is equal to again 12 volts. So the given voltage is equally shared, not equally, sorry. The given voltage is shared in the load. That is, load means here the resistors. The given voltage is shared in the resistors of the circuit. I will draw the circuit diagram. Please, you must include the circuit diagram. The battery, 12 volt battery. So R1, R2, R3, this is 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm. This is the circuit diagram. The current flowing is, what we found out, the current flowing is 2 amps. So the current flowing through the entire circuit is same, because the resistance are in series. The total resistance is 6 ohm. 1 plus 2 plus 3 is 6 ohms. The current is same, that is 2 ampere. This is the source voltage. And the voltage drop across this is, how much voltage is there across this R1? 2. Across this R2, what is the voltage? 4. Across this 6 volts. This shows the voltage drop across each and every resistor. So this 12 volt, 2 amps, 1, 2, 3. So this is a very neat diagram for you for describing this question. So you do not miss the circuit diagram. You can pause your video and you write everything. Then you move on to the next video. Then if you have any doubts regarding the theory based on this, you just immediately write down the doubts and get it clear with me. Okay, let's move on to the next question.